He's live from London. Welcome, Boy George.
Hello, how are you?
Very, very well. You teased the Fantabulosa tour, what was it, more than 2 years ago when you were here in Australia? Does it feel amazing to have it finally happening?
Yeah, it's really exciting because you're right. I announced it on The Voice the last season I did. And obviously, we all thought it was going to happen a lot sooner, but now we have dates in March, which is really exciting. I'm actually working on the project right now, so choosing, you know, some great songs that maybe I never really considered singing before, like things like Sympathy for the Devil by The Stones, Heroes by Bowie, Here Comes the Sun. I'm plundering all these amazing songs and thinking, oh, I sound pretty good doing this.
Describe it as a sparkling music event. What can we expect from the concert?
Well, when we used to go to Ibiza, some of the chill out sets would take you on these kind of musical journeys, and you know, people would drop things. Like, I remember being in a club in Ibiza and somebody dropped Islands in the Stream, and everyone lost their mind because secretly everybody loves things they know, even if they think they hate them. Not that I'm going to be doing Islands in the Stream, but I might. But yeah, it's just kind of creating a kind of soundscape of things you know. And I'm messing around with some of my old songs, doing different versions of them. I've done a reggae version of Victims, which some people might like and some people might hate. But it's about taking people on a sort of different musical journey. And we've got some amazing guests, Courtney Act, Moju, Adair. You know, so it's going to be, and it's celebrating, you know, diversity, really, the effect that diversity has had on pop culture.
How fun does a party in Ibiza sound? Yeah. It has been so long since that was possible. I remember seeing Elton John pop up at, there was some lunch on there and he put his new song on or something and everyone was just dancing around these clubs. And I just thought, that is what the whole world needs right now, is a party in Ibiza.
Well, music as well, I think, you know, because, you know, everybody loves music, particularly Australians. You know, there's really big music fans in Australia, so having done The Voice, you know, I know how much people get excited when they hear music, and that's kind of want to bring that excitement to this show, really.
You mentioned Courtney Act. We love Courtney Act on this show. How did you two cross paths?
Well, we actually met in Australia. We had a cup of tea in Australia, but obviously Courtney was in England a lot and Courtney won Big Brother. So I watched that, you know, because it was like, you know, I think the first time we'd ever seen a drag queen on TV talking common sense, it was kind of like, what's going on, you know? And that's how we met, when Courtney won Big Brother in the UK.
I love how you had a cup of tea. That's real, real Aussie. You came out here, had a cup of tea. Very English.
I'm sure that's exactly what happens in Ibiza. Sorry, I'm reading this out because I don't quite believe this is possible. Is it true that on the 6th of December, you are planning to drop 60 new songs? 60, 6-0.
Well, I'm going to do it. Maybe because December the 6th is the day I'm going to court with John Moss. Whether it happens or not is another story. So I wanted to do it on that day to make the day about something other than the court case. But now I'm pushing it sort of just before Christmas. And yes, I am absolutely going to drop 60 songs in one day, all at the same time.
60?
That's what I've been doing.
So that's like six albums at once.
Yeah. Well, there's been lots of gaps in my career. You know, when I was DJing, when I was doing other things, you know, that I didn't make music. So this year has given me this incredible space and freedom just to keep writing and writing. And obviously at this point, we're now going through everything to make sure it's all tipped up and great. And I have to say, I'm pretty happy with what I've done.
So obviously this was a very fertile creative period for you that led you to create this much stuff. What's coming out? Like, what is there a common theme? Is it about something in particular, or is it just all over the place?
I think my song, well, I think life is all over the place. And I think the way you think about things changes. But as a writer, you know, you understand that when you're writing songs, it's just narrative. I mean, most of what we think is conceptual as human beings, we make up stuff on a 24-hour basis. So songs are really just made up stories or your views of what's going on. But I have explored every musical sound from jazz to, you know, electronic to house music. I'm just doing what I want, because rock and roll is supposed to be about freedom. And guess what? That's what I'm doing.
Boy George, we don't have much time left, but I've got a question I've always wondered about and really want to ask you. Have you ever smuggled something in a hat?
No, I haven't actually, because usually when you're traveling with a hat box, people always open it and they go, what's that? And I would go, best ever one was when I landed in Australia with these trunks of hats for The Voice. And the guy opens it and he goes, what's that? And I said, the hats. And he said, are you going to sell them? And I said, who else would buy them apart from me?
Can I just point out, you do sound like someone, though, who has really figured out how to smuggle stuff.
Yeah.
What are you trying to say? I watched that program, Border Control. I would never smuggle anything anywhere.
I think on Border Control, you're fine. It's my kind that are in more trouble.
Listen, when you got tattoos, you always get stopped.
Oh, okay.
You know, it's a standard thing. It's like, oh, weirdo tattoos, you know, they stop you. So, you know, you get used to it, you know.
There's a rumour that a Culture Club biopic could be in the works. Is it happening?
It is, and they're talking to this young artist called Youngblood. I don't know if you know him in Australia. Yeah. He's pretty big over here. They're looking at him to play me. So I've been hanging out with him a bit, which is great. He's the punk rocker.
What would be the hardest part about playing you? What are you going to warn him about?
I think to do less, because I think when people tend to play a gay man, they just think they've got to do it in a certain way, and I am many things.
What would the hat budget be for the film?
Maybe I'll be kind and let them borrow some hats after I've smuggled them in.
Hey, just before we go, you mentioned you had a cup of tea here. What else are you looking forward to having when you come back? You love Australia. You're down here often.
I do love Australia. You know what? I haven't been back for a couple of years, but since we've announced dates, every single person I work with on The Voice has been in touch. You know, it's like, oh, we're coming. And then, you know, there's obviously going to be some DJ gigs there as well. So, yeah, I'm going to make the most of my time in Australia. I loved being there every year. It was amazing.
Well, we can't wait to have you back. For all the information about the Fantabulosa tour, head to our website. Boy George, thank you so much for joining the project tonight.
Thank you. Love you, Australia.